Hello everybody, I'm finally back. I've been out camping for a few weeks and before that I did some extra work. But now I'm ready to tie fly. It's been quite a long time since the last one. So I'm gonna start with something not that advanced, and it's also a fly pattern by request from Elias. So in this video we're gonna do or tie the Durham Ranger. So let's begin. Okay, so I attached the gilt to the hook just to speed things up, and a tying Price Tanner's version. So then we have the tag silver tinsel. I'm going to use flat. Just building up a little bit here. Cutting the leftovers. And adding some wax to the thread. Now it's time for the tail. Good. Adding some more bags to the thread. Next step would be Indian crow. I'm going to use a substitute today. So. Just cutting the edges of the feather. Sorry. Some more wax. Going backwards again. Then we have ostrich heart. Start to wrap that. Securing the ostrich herd. So, cutting the leftovers. We have flat thin cell and twist. So I'm gonna start to cut the twist. Adding the flat tinsel to the hook. Just tying it in with a few wraps of the thread. Going back. And it's time for the twist. Tying that one in as well. Now it's time for the floss, yellow silk floss. So I'm tying that one in, changing to my gloves, and then finish tying in the floss. Adding the gloves. securing the silk floss with the thread, of course, a few wraps, then removing the gloves. Sorry. There we go. Then we have a bandier feather dyed yellow. So let me find a good one. Like that one. So I'm just gonna prepare it before I tie it in. So I'm just doubling the hackle. There we are. So I'm just waxing the thread with a light wax to tie that one in. As you see, I have doubled the hackle here. I can make a video of how to do that someday. Now to the favorite part of it. Some more wax to the thread. Then we have orange silver. So, adding a bit to the thread, just spin it on with my hands. I don't like to do it in a double loop, a duping loop, because I want to be able to brush it out later. So let me see. Bit more. trying to make it even section. It's going to be three color, orange, brown, and then black. Very brown. Let's add some of that as well. Now the black silver. Do a little bit more of the black since the hackle is gonna cover quite a lot of it. So I just see, so I can see the section in the body anyhow. So there we are. Cleaning the table. Toothbrush, just to brush it out. It's a good tool. So now I got some volume in the body, as you can see. So let's start with the flat tinsel. Thank you. There we are. Cutting the leftovers. Then we have the twist. Need to reset the last one. Now it looks better. Cutting the leftover. My dog is playing in the background. Thank you for that. There we are, the body hackle in place. So cutting the leftovers. Then we should add light blue. Light blue hacker. Let's see which one we select today. Let's try this one. The front hackle, you want it to be a bit longer than the body hackle, of course. adding some backs to the thread, and then we start with the front tackle. So I'm pulling the fibers backwards. So I'm just gonna try this feather. I'm not sure I'm gonna keep it because I think it's all over the place, which it is. So I'm gonna change neck. Now you see the fibers go all over the place here. So I'm gonna take the other one. So, tying that one in instead. Should look much nicer. And there we are, not too much. That's the body of Durham Ranger, price tenant pattern. So I'm gonna continue with the wing in the morning. So that's how I tied the price tenant version of the Durham Ranger. I hope you're gonna enjoy this first part, and tomorrow I'm gonna do the second part, finish the wing and the whole fly. And so you can watch it tomorrow in the afternoon. I hope you enjoyed the video. I did. So with that, see you tomorrow in the next video. Okay, bye.
Lately nothing's coming my way. Keep drowning every bit of my devotion, sinking deeper every day. And lately I am missing my reflection in every muddy puddle on the pavement, driving every thought into distortion.